2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
Arena as the Golden State Warriors look to grab a win in front of the home crowd here. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Brent Berry and Greg Anthony. We've got David Aldridge reporting from the sideline. Last game for the Warriors, they pick up the W against the Spurs. And what really made that outcome a surprise was how lopsided it was.
And this is why depth is so important. You know, next man up, and it's pretty much the philosophy for every good team in our league.
You're going to have injuries. You're going to have nights where there's foul troubles or the starters just struggle. So you need a strong bench to remain consistent in this league.
And now the opening lineup for Phoenix. Booker and Warren on the perimeter. Chris and Chandler are up front. And it's Payton in at the point. Chris can't hit. Looking at the Suns, they want to turn it around after the loss to Denver.
I mean, frustrating when missed free throws become contagious. Really the Achilles heel in that one.
Yeah, you try to put up these scoring runs, and it hurts when you all of a sudden just give away free points from the free throw line.
That's in, coming off an assist from Payton. Chris has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. And Brent, in your younger years, your dad, of course, played for the Golden State Warriors. You have connections with the Bay Area, certainly. Any memories of watching the old Warriors team play?
Well, of course, Kevin. I was a ball boy when I was 4 years old, and I remember getting into the locker room and, you know, having a chance to get on the practice court and riding to the arena with my dad. And then my years in high school when I made my way there to watch Run TMC and spent my summers with Chris Mullin trying to get myself ready for the NBA. I love the Bay Area. I love where I'm from. And I have to admit it, I love the Warriors. He used that screen to perfection and got a wide open look to knock down the jumper.
Here's Thompson. The shot will not fall. The Suns go the other way with it. The dish now to Payton. Chandler, the pass to Warren. And Petrulia pulls it down.
Somehow, some way, he couldn't get that one to fall from in between. Got to take advantage of the weak defense when you can.
And Phoenix pushing it up now. Warren with the ball. No good. That's miss number two. He's one for three. Thompson for three. Green kicks to Kerr. And again, it's the Warriors missing. Warren dishes to Payton. Here's a screen by Chris. Booker against Thompson. And Booker kicks to Chris. No good on the three. The Warriors trailing. Down low. And there's Green on the assist by Thompson.
Draymond Green showing off some finishing touch around the rim.
David Aldridge had a chance to catch up with head coach Steve Kerr. What do you have to say?
Well, Kevin, he expects their interior defense to be airtight. Said rim protection is something we really do well. Our ability to contest shots allows us to become more aggressive on the perimeter. Makes it a win-win. We'll see if all of that holds up for them tonight. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Their game plan appears to be putting that defense front and center in this one.
Yeah, and that's where they're going to put their energy early on. They don't want this to become a run and gun type of game.
Well, they've got the kind of defense, I think, GA set up so that that doesn't happen. As aggressive as they are at that end, it's very hard to make it a high-scoring game against this team.
Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
And, folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
Pass to Pachulia. Payton against Curry. Outside for Durant. And so it looks like the Warriors will retain possession here. Now a chance, guys, to examine the rebounding numbers over the past months for Len.
In the last few months, the rebounding has sort of taken a bit of a dive for him, and a lot of factors could be the cause, but it's a trend that coach would probably like to see him reverse.
Andre Iguodala, he's checked in for the Warriors. Here's Thompson. The shot's good on the assist by Iguodala. That's 7 points for Klay Thompson. As we've seen, many teams play a little bit of a soft zone defensively. What's the best way, you think, Brent, to counteract that when you're trying to run your half-court offense?
Well, the best way to counteract anybody who's softening up on the backside of the zone is to overload that side of the court, Kevin. So now all of a sudden, if you make a shift with more players on one side of the floor, there's no way for three to cover two on the backside. That's where teams can gain incredible advantage.
Well executed, great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Well, it's like Thanksgiving out there, carving out space off the screen. Just couldn't complete the play.
Iguodala with the steal. And now here comes Iguodala leading the break. And Andre Iguodala with the slam.
Iguodala out on the lane, running well. That's something he can do.
And the replay is courtesy of Under Armour. Unleash chaos. It was a great sequence from the steal all the way to the finish at the other end. Now, here's Ulis. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Jackson kicks to Daniels. Pass to Jackson. Pocket six. Some nice ball movement here by the Suns. This one for three. Phoenix with a new shot clock. Jackson setting the pick here for Ulis. Jackson a screen on Curry. Daniels. And he's good on the three ball.
And they can't allow him too many open looks like that. That's just inviting trouble.
Durant with a screen on Jackson. There's the pick. Iguodala kicks to Thompson. Green the screen. Durant for three. Sinks the triple. Durant's got 5 points so far.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Ulis with it. Now Green defending. Ulis passes to Len. Off on the layup.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
And now the Suns, a fast break. And there's Daniel. That's good on the assist by Jackson. He's got five.
And you gotta love how Jackson shares the ball with his teammates. You gotta like that unselfish mindset.
Green, the screen. Curry outside. Another three for Golden State.
Outstanding start from three-point range. Their shooters are on fire.
Suns trail by nine. Now, here's Ulis. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Len, a screen. There's the pick. Jackson from long range. And no good. Klay Thompson has been leading the charge for the Golden State Warriors. He finishes with 9 points in the quarter. The D is having all sorts of problems with them. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And Tyson Chandler, known for being a great teammate, a very vocal leader, certainly. He talked about how important that is for an NBA locker room.
Players do the policing. Coach sets a standard, but players individually call out other players, you know, whether it be timeout, whether it be halftime, whether it be pulling guys to the side, you know, in practice. When you have that going on, you see multiple guys doing that, that's when you know you have a good team.
Don't you need a player like this, of Chandler's caliber and character, Greg, to make that kind of a team work? That feel in the locker room, that leadership role that everybody believes in and respects?
No doubt about it, Kevin. And that weighty stature is built on experience and credentials, as you mentioned, like having that championship ring or being an all-star. But when you have it and use it that way, the coach doesn't have to worry about the locker room because Chandler has got that covered.
Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. What do you guys think about the Warriors here so far?
And boy, I tell you, it didn't take them long to find their rhythm. Strong offense through one.
A nice game plan coming in, and right now sticking to it. A nice lead that they have.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, Young is out there with Iguodala. Then there's West, and there's Livingston, and it's McCaw in at the two spot. And here's Young following the three from Tyler Ulis. Picked by West. Jumper off the screen. It's good. Iguodala's got his second basket.
Iguodala's shot selection pretty good right there. Good at taking the high percentage opportunities.
What is nice to see from Iguodala in the tail end of his career, Brent, is that he has actually gotten more efficient from the floor.
Well, Iguodala does a good job of picking and choosing his spots, and I think having the teammates that he has, drawing that kind of attention, guys like Curry, Durant, and certainly Klay Thompson from the perimeter, opens up opportunities that Iguodala just can read so very well. Doesn't need to be risky with anything he does offensively.
There's Ulis following the score by Golden State. Offensive rebound. It's Jackson atop the key. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Livingston kicks it to West. And the pass to McCaw. Tries it from the top of the key, and it's Daniels with the rebound.
Wow, huge sigh of relief for the defense on that possession. You cannot give mid-range shooters any space like that to operate.
And the basket for the fourth time from the field. He's a healthy 4-for-6. Warriors leading by 3. Livingston dishes to West. Pass to McCaw. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Can't hit from 12. Daniels passes to Len, and it's good for 2.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
They set the pick. Ulis with a steal, and now the Suns a fast break. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor. Guys back and forth this first half.
And this could continue to go back and forth the entire way.
And Young kicks to Livingston. Stolen by Doug. Now, here's Ulis. He's covered by Livingston. Ulis with it. He has 5. 6 to shoot. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good. And now it's a 3-point Phoenix lead.
And after that ragged first quarter, they're getting some momentum, some confidence. Nice flow.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here. We see it so often. A player will languish in one system, then flourish in another. Brent, during your 14-year career, which coach's system fit you the best?
Well, I think my years in Seattle, we opened up the offense a little bit. I had the opportunity to play more of a point off guard. But I also enjoyed the structure of what Greg Popovich's system in San Antonio offered up as well. It's always interesting, Kevin, with players who are languishing on benches for other ball clubs, how general managers start to assess whether that guy can be part of something great if they were to bring him in. I had the opportunity to play for a lot of great coaches and thought that I mixed up my game enough to make it a long career.
And the Warriors with the completely new five on the floor. And here we can now take a look at how the ratio was between the threes and the twos last season for the Warriors.
And they really based almost their entire offense around the three-point shot. Spread the floor, space the defense, and if the deep shots aren't falling, at least it should open things up inside.
And here is Payton after the three-pointer from Klay Thompson. A nice shot by Booker.
Bringing that three-point percentage up quite a bit this quarter, shooting it well. The lead's going to get a little bit bigger if they can keep this up.
Green dishes to Thompson. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Thompson's got the game tied up here for the Warriors.
Pretty much poor defensive effort there. You have to get a hand in his face when he's spotting up from distance.
Bender the pass to Warren. Chandler is screen. Off the pick. The Warriors pull it in. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Curry, wide open. Bender with the rebound.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
Payton kicks to Warren. Chandler with the screen on Durant. Here's Warren. Drops it in from 14 feet away. Warren's got his second bucket of the game to go.
And boy, did he ever sell the pump fake. Worked to absolute perfection.
There's a screen. Durant dishes to Thompson. And the shot is good. Thompson's got 8 points here in this quarter.
And Klay using his size down low to carve out just enough room, and then the high release point. Couldn't get to it.
Chandler is screen. Lobbed up there for Chandler. Stolen by Thompson. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. And Durant gets it to go.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both ends. Nicely done.
Chandler with the screen on Curry. Payton attacking. Warren kicks to Payton. Near the three-point line, it's Booker. Again, Phoenix.
This is the kind of guy that you wake up in a cold sweat the night before you play him. Just a matchup nightmare. Tricky, confident, and he takes on all comers. Commending the unselfish play there. What vision on that pass.
And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of basketball. Warriors ahead, up by 4. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Draymond Green. Draymond, big front court on the other team. Was the game plan to make them adjust to you?
Absolutely. We know their size is what they were going to bank on. Pull them away from the rim a little bit. We were able to knock some shots down.
You look comfortable, and they did not. Thanks a lot, Draymond. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Some big-time action already in this one. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Klay Thompson brought his A game early tonight. He ended up with 17 points, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
Well, I love the way they're pushing the tempo, beating the defense down the floor, filling the lanes, finishing with authority, Ernie, getting to the rim, and finishing hard.
And over to Shaq. What did you think about Phoenix?
Well, one thing happened that really helped them out. Their bench came in and played absolutely beautiful. Gave them a huge boost. Not just trying to hold court, but actually putting points on the scoreboard. These guys should be starting, Ernie.
That's it for halftime. Glad you could join us, as now we send you back to the action for the start of the third quarter.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. Klay Thompson has been sensational.
And I love the game plan in that first half. They really valued each possession.
Efficient so far with the shots that he's taken. His contributions have been fantastic.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Warriors leading by 4. And Brent, something you have to praise Kerr for last season. He did an excellent job of bringing all that talent together and getting them on the same page. Not very easy with star players and big names.
Well, he had to tinker with the rotation a little bit, and then he had to also make sure that guys had confidence in their ability, and Steve was able to do that. The interesting part about all of that, Kevin, is that there were a lot of games that Steve was not there for. And for that kind of leadership, that kind of message, to be sustained in the absence of your head coach, that should tell you all you need to know about just how solid the ground is for the Golden State Warriors.
Starting the second half, here's Jay Triano's five. Chris and Chandler are up front. Booker and Warren on the perimeter. And it's Payton in at the one. And here is Chandler after the three-pointer from Klay Thompson. Pass to Chris. Just four to shoot. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Booker.
And with the chance, let's take a look now at the numbers for Durant. Fourth in blocks, sixth in scoring, and tremendous confidence and consistency at the foul line. He ranks among the top 15 in free throw percentage.
And yeah, he's been a brutal shot blocker all season long. As you said, top five in the league, he's a dangerous force to face inside. And here in the second half of play, we're just over a minute in. Picked by Pachulia, feeds it to Green. Fires the three. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Thompson's got his fifth assist in this one. Suns trail by 10. Now Payton. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Here's Chris. And the shot no good, a bit short. Durant, wide open, he fires. And another basket for Golden State.
Well, for a tall guy, Durant has such dexterity and rhythm on the catch and shoot. It's just interesting to watch.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix.
How about last year, Draymond Green pulled off one of the more improbable and impossible statistical games. He had a triple-double with points not even being involved. First ever in the NBA. 4 points, 12 boards, 10 assists, and 10 steals. Wow.
Now let's turn to the 2K leaderboard for a look at the squads that have the most points in transition over the past 10 games. The Warriors, number one.
I mean, no doubt for me that they've hit their stride the last few weeks. I mean, they are punishing the defenses with that up-tempo style.
You know, Brent, thinking back to Draymond's triple-double, he also had 5 blocks in that game. He was 6 points away, in fact, from getting a quadruple-double and 5 from getting a quadruple-double without points.
As unreal stat line, and probably a lot of people who still get newspapers, Kevin, looked at those numbers and thought, wow, the printing machine must be broken. That game was on another level, and to just have 4 points in that contest shows you that Draymond Green puts the emphasis on all the other things that he does so well.
Four on the shot clock. Thompson inside the line, and another basket for Golden State.
Guys, his consistency in terms of shooting has really helped them seize control.
There's a screen by Chris. Trying his luck deep. That's good. And it's Payton with the assist. Chris has got it back down to a single-digit deficit for Phoenix. Timeout called the Warriors. You've heard the rumors, Brent, the death of the big man, but with guys like Towns and Porzingis and others entering the league that can play on the perimeter and still have that length to make a difference inside, could we see a big man renaissance, or at least maybe see him have more of an impact than people are giving him credit for right now?
Well, I think what we're seeing is the evolution of the five spot, Kevin. So it's not that the big man is lost. It's that the big man's doing a lot of the things that the little man used to be asked to do, and that is shooting threes, handle the ball, make some decisions at the top of the key, be a playmaker. It's fascinating to watch guys with this sort of size and this sort of skill, and also being this young, having such a tremendous impact for the organizations they're playing for.
And up and down this Suns roster, there is a ton of youth. One of the younger teams in our league last season, and that was weighted with Tyson Chandler's age. A lot of young players looking to make their mark here in the NBA.
Sun changes for Phoenix. Alex Lenz checked in for Chandler. Jackson comes in for Warren. And Daniels subbed in for Elfrid Payton. Now here's Livingston. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Here's Iguodala. That shot, no good. Now the Suns take it the other way. And last season, the Suns broke their franchise record for the youngest starting five the team has ever put on the court on multiple occasions.
Yeah, and with those young lineups, you can see the benefits, but also the concerns. I mean, they got a lot of extended looks at young players, and this team figures to have a bright future. But let's face it, there were some inconsistent stretches because of that youth. It's always difficult for a young group to learn how to become efficient and effective in the half court.
And Phoenix has possession following the score by Golden State. Nice ball movement by Phoenix. Here's Daniels, and it's off from three-point range. Warriors leading by nine. Pick by West. Stolen by Len. Booker outside. Outside Jackson. Good, and a nice assist from Booker. Jackson's got 5 points so far.
How about Devin Booker scanning the floor and finding the right option?
McCaw kicks to Iguodala. And here's Young from the arc. And another three for Golden State.
A little tit-for-tat action going on the back-to-back trades.
Yeah, a little gamesmanship from range could force both defenses to maybe extend out a little further.
Here is Daniels. He's got 10. There's a screen by Chris. Jackson, a screen on Young. Shot clock at 6. That's good, and the Warrior lead is cut to just 7 points in the basket from Daniels.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Now a timeout called by Golden State.
Well, you know what this Suns team wants to do when they go up against you? They are looking to get out in the open floor and get easy baskets off transition. One of the best teams in the league when it comes to capitalizing on the break.
And in general, this Suns team looks to push the tempo, Greg, and play at a very high pace whenever they can.
You know, if you look over the history of the franchise, they've always been at their best when they played that style. The Suns and that run-and-gun mentality just seem to go hand-in-hand. And I think also it happens to work well with the athletes that are presently on this roster.
Is here for the Warriors. Green comes in for Young. And it's Thompson in for Patrick McCall. And Phoenix also making a switch. Bender, he's checked in for Len. Now here's Livingston. Here's Thompson. Up and in. That's his 10th make in the contest. He has only taken 13 shots.
Man, Klay Thompson, when he gets moving like this, big, big things happen.
Pass to Chris. Booker, left side. The Warriors pull it in, and this is their first time matched up with the Suns this season.
And they rolled over this team last season, beating them every time they faced off.
Yeah, it was a completely one-sided season series, and that was no surprise to anyone. This first game between them should give us an idea if they're on a little more even ground this season.
Durant's checked in for West, and then for Phoenix. Dudley comes in for Marquese Chris, and it's Payton in for Troy Daniels. ...44 seconds left to play in the third. Bender the pass to Booker. Clock at 6. Shoots over Livingston. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. 7 points for Devin Booker.
Booker effective that time. Close to the basket, taking his time to cash in.
Iguodala kicks to Thompson. And he's fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up.
I mean, the stroke looks good. He's moving well out there. What a sensational start to this game. Perfect from the field.
And he'll be shooting his first free throw of the game here. The Warriors making a switch here. Curry's checked in. And the Suns making a change here as well. Warren's checked in. That free throw good from Thompson.
And Clay is such a great two-way player, a tremendous shooter, but a good job playing perimeter guys, both point guards and two guards for his position.
There's a good screen. Payton kicks to Booker. Over Iguodala. That's good, and the Warrior lead is cut down to 8 on the bucket from Booker. And so it's the Golden State Warriors holding on to an 8-point lead heading into the break. They're feeling very confident, shooting the ball with great efficiency and dictating the pace. Back to the action after this word. Now let's listen in to head coach Steve Kerr.
Get a couple stops, we get a couple runouts, we get into our flow, all right? Keep the ball moving.
Steve Kerr asking his guys just to, you know, keep up the pace, playing selfishly, basically be yourself, stay guys, stay in character.
Yeah, I mean, he knows what this team is capable of. Just looking for a couple of plays to really kind of kickstart that engine and give them that little sustainable groove.
Just one quarter left in regulation. Welcome back, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. Inside, we've got Draymond at the 4 and Pachulia to his side. Lethal shooting pair of Clay and KD out on the perimeter. And it's Curry in at the point guard. So that's the group out there for Golden State. Now here's Payton after the miss from Clay Thompson. Payton outside. It's stolen by Curry. Lays it in off the breakaway.
Sprinting down the floor is the key to a great fast break, and Steph putting on the afterburners there.
And that replay presented by Under Armour showing us the fantastic steal that led to that fast break finish. Another unleash chaos moment. Now here's Payton. He dishes it to Booker. He kicks it to Chandler. It's stolen by Curry. Drops in the breakaway layup. And now it's a 9-point Warrior lead.
And defensively, neither side able to get many stops.
Well, it's one of those nights where if a team down the stretch can get one or two stops, they may win it.
Offensive rebound. And here is Payton. Kicks to Booker. Chandler is screened. The drive by Booker. And Pachulia pulls it down. Warriors leading by 9. Durant with it. Now Payton defending. Curry dishes to Thompson. Back to Curry. Over Payton. Curry can't get it to go.
And that was an easy one there. Just a missed opportunity.
Well, sometimes everything can go right, but the shot doesn't go down. Nothing there is automatic.
Warriors have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Shots good by Green.
Huh, imagine that. Draymond Green bringing energy to the game. Where have I seen that before?
Phoenix calls timeout.
One thing we've seen from the Warriors is that this team's ability to turn things on and just put teams away is remarkable. They hit a switch, the defense causes some turnovers, and in the blink of an eye, 10, 12, 15 points, and you're down big.
And that burst of scoring and intensity with the Warriors. You know, Brent, sometimes it feels like they only need to play 6 to 10 good minutes of basketball to win a game.
Yeah, sometimes that's all they do, Kevin, and then they let the defense take over. And I think that that's what's most amazing about this Warriors roster. It's relentless, but it's relentless on both ends of the floor. You sleep on defense, and offensively they take advantage. And if you're not sharp yourself on the offensive end, the Warriors are just too good down there.
He's checked in for Dragan Bendis. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Guys, during that last break, I listened to the Suns coach address his team. He got on him. He said he's got to see more intensity. He said, we put ourselves in this hole, and we've got to work our way out of it. Show me you've got what it takes, guys.
Now, here's Thompson. After the miss from Elfrid Payton, and Thompson gets it to go.
Well, he's got a baton in the right hand as he's orchestrating what's going on. A maestro, if you will.
Chandler with the screen on Curry. Payton kicks to Chris. That's good. And it's Payton with the assist. Payton's got his fifth assist in this one.
Back at you. Well, that's payback for the three on the other end.
A little mano y mano there, entertaining, but you also want to keep your teammates involved.
A little tit-for-tat action going on the back-to-back trades.
Yeah, a little gamesmanship from range could force both defenses to maybe extend out a little further.
Now, here's Warren. Over Green, that's good, and the Warrior lead is cut down now to just 12 points with the basket from Warren.
A defensive mindset has to maybe get to the mid-range. They didn't do a good job pressuring the shooter on that possession.
Here is Durant. Here's Thompson. And a kind roll that time off the rim as that one falls. Thompson's got the lead up to 14 now for the Warriors. Payton kicks to Warren. There's a screen by Chris. Here's Payton. Down to five on the shot clock. Chris with another miss. And it's the Warriors' ball. They're on a 14-5 run here. Curry kicks to Durant. Tyson Chandler grabs the board. Chandler's got his third rebound tonight. Here's Warren. A putback. Great positioning on the putback.
Chris finding a nice rhythm in this game and getting to the spots on the floor where he can be most effective.
Curry kicks to Thompson. Picked by Pachulia. Back to Curry. Shoots the three. That's in. Coming off the assist from Thompson. And it's 13 points for Steph Curry.
And defensively, you've got to make a greater effort working over the screens.
Yeah, it's a bit of a lazy play right there. You're hoping that the guy misses the shot without really doing your job and challenging it.
Now, here's Warren. Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a three-second violation.
And with the Warriors, their ability to score in bunches really is unmatched throughout the league. They'll be going along with the team, and all of a sudden they have that 20-point lead like 3 minutes. It can happen so fast that I think at times the other teams are shell-shocked.
And the technical free throw is good. And talking about the Warriors and their ability to build a lead very quickly, the shooting they have, Greg, is a very big part of how they can just bury a team.
It is. Their shooting, especially from deep, but also their defense. One kind of feeds the other in terms of how they can steamroll teams and create that momentum. And only the special teams can put a game away with a five-minute run, but this is one that has consistently done it over the last 3 years. And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Warriors.
You know, it's tough to put your finger on the deciding factor in this one, but I'd say that the shooting accuracy made the difference.
Yeah, I think you're on point, Kevin. They got better looks, and that tends to lead to a better field goal percentage.
And this will now push it to a total of 44 games in the win column on the season. And, you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Klay Thompson.
He just looked like an orchestrator out there. His teammates kept running to the open spot, and he found them time and time again.
With the premium placed on outside shooting, Brent, plus defensive rules that lessen the need to defend in isolation, will we see guys playing for more years than ever before? Less wear and tear because there's less of it inside in games.
You know, it's a great point, Kevin. I think that you're right about that. I also think that whatever we're doing off the court in terms of the players with nutrition and training regimen, that's going to be another reason why we'll see players be very effective well into their late 30s and sometimes into their early 40s, which is about my limit, Kev. I'm still effective at 45.
You are. Very effective at 45.
Take control of your heart and soul. Your body is free and whole. Dance for your hands, dance for your hands, dance for your
Payton outside. There's the pick. He feeds it to Booker. 1:10 left to play in the final quarter. Phoenix, no good that time either. Warriors leading by 16. Curry kicks to Thompson. Inside, Durant. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson.
And saving their best for last. Tremendous run here to seal the win.
And you could just see everything coming together like a perfect storm, and they just rolled on through.
And now here's Chris. There's a screen by Chris. Clock at 4. Phoenix needs to get off a shot. Again, the miss by Booker. And it's Golden State's ball. 18 points separating the teams. That's the biggest lead of the game. Durant, the pass to Thompson. Durant with a screen on Booker. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock.
And you can tell they're ready to start celebrating a well-deserved victory here tonight.
Yeah, you can see the fans. They've already started celebrating themselves. A gutty performance.
Again, the miss by Booker. So we see the Warriors taking the game here. They poured it on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks a lot. Steph, what was the key that had your offense going so well tonight?
Obviously, guys have to make shots, and when we're creating and moving our bodies and the ball's moving, we're not turning it over. You know, we're tough to guard, and everybody had confidence tonight to go out there and make plays, so that's contagious, and we got to find that next game if we want to keep this going.
Obviously, the way you guys want to play, Steph. Thank you. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that about wraps it up. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.